morning, good brothers and good sisters, and praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. A very good morning to you, my brothers and sisters. Rise and shine. Well, we'll get the first joke coming of the morning.
Yeah. In the court of the law, the judge asked the defendant,
okay,
you killed your neighbor, beating him with the hammer.
Okay.
Do you plead guilty? The defendant replied, yes, sir. And there was a man in the crowd.
Okay.
He shouted, you dirty rat. And still the process continued. The judge again asked the defendant, asking, you killed your neighbor's son with a hammer. Do you plead guilty? And he said, yes, my lord.
I'm guilty. Okay.
And that person in the crowd again shouted, you stupid dirty rat, you mean creature. Got disturbed, and also the judge sent for him, called him to the so he was called there and asked him, don't you know the discipline of the court, that you should be silent in the court and you are not supposed to scream here? Then why did you shout, and what is your problem? He said, this very man, when I had gone to him, he's my neighbor. I had gone to ask him for the hammer. He said he does not have a hammer. But how did you now kill his neighbors with the hammer?
Okay.
He's angry. When he asked for the hammer, he did not have the hammer. Now he's killing.
Oh my God. Hi, Jesus. Good one. Father, today, I love this man, Bishop Fulton Sheen. He used to say, I spent 1 hour before the Blessed Sacrament every day. That is where I derive my strength. That is why my preachings are so powerful. Why is the Holy Hour important?
It's not only Fulton Sheen, but also there are so many great preachers.
Oh, really?
Mother Teresa of Calcutta?
Oh yes, she used to. Correct.
She would not meet anybody after the Mass. She'll spend 1 hour before the Blessed Sacrament. And even if the biggest VIP comes, she will not move out of the church. Because for her, Jesus is the greatest VIP.
Amen.
So who can be greater than Jesus Christ?
Amen.
So today, why we have problem with this Holy Hour or spending time before the Blessed Sacrament is that we have made the worldly things more important than the VVIP Jesus Christ. We don't realize His importance in our life.
Correct.
You see, from the life of the Fulton Sheen or the great preachers, saints and Mother Teresa, Jesus is the person whom you have to give first priority, not the worldly things.
Correct.
Okay. So what is the important of the Holy Hour to spend time before the Blessed Sacrament? So, the first and foremost, it is the greatest need, that is the greatest need of the church as well as of individual person, says our Holy Father, or Pope Paul II. He said, the church and the world have a great need of Eucharistic adoration. It's the need. And also, John Paul II life, I'm speaking something from there again. This is a personal invitation to you from Jesus Himself. Jesus waits for us in this sacrament of love. Jesus, you know, waiting with love for us, come to me and I'm waiting for you here. Again, John Paul II, these are the words of John Paul II. And continuing again, he said, Jesus is continuing on you. Jesus is counting on you because Eucharist is the center of life. Every member of the church must be vigilant in seeing that the sacrament of love shall be at the center of the life of the people of God, so that through all the manifestations of the worship, due Him shall be given back. Love for love, and truly become the life of our souls.
Amen.
That is what Pope John Paul II had
said.
And your hour with Jesus is the in the Blessed Sacrament will repair for evils of the world and bring abundant peace on earth. Let us be generous with our time in going to meet Jesus and ready to make reparation for the great evils of the world. Let your adoration never cease, because there is so much of evils in the world that our time before the Blessed Sacrament, praying for the sinners, that will bring changes in the world. Day and night Jesus dwells in the Blessed Sacrament because you are the most important person in the world.
Amen.
For that reason we have to go before the Blessed Sacrament.
Yes.
Christ is reserved in our churches as the spiritual center of the heart of the community, the universal church, and all humanity. Since within the veil of the species, Christ is contained, the invisible heart of the church, the Redeemer of the world, the center of all hearts. By Him all things are, and of whom we exist.
Amen.
So we belong to Christ.
Yes.
Jesus wants us to do more than to go to Sunday Mass.
Yes.
It's something more that He wants us to do.
Yes.
Our communal worship at Mass must go together with our personal worship of Jesus, Eucharistic adoration, in order that our love may be complete.
Please.
It's
Amen.
Not enough that Sunday
Amen.
Worship.
Amen.
Okay?
Amen.
You grow spiritually with each moment you spend with Jesus.
Amen.
Our essential commitment in life is to preserve and advance constantly in Eucharistic life and Eucharistic piety, and to grow spiritually in the climate of the Holy Eucharist. Then again, the best time you spend on earth is with Jesus, your best friend, in the Blessed Sacrament.
It's
the best moment of your life.
Amen. Amen.
How great is the value of conversation with Christ in the Blessed Sacrament, for there is nothing more consoling on earth, nothing more efficacious for advancing along the road of holiness.
Amen.
Just as you can't be exposed to the sun without receiving its rays, neither can you come to Jesus exposed in the Blessed Sacrament without receiving the divine rays of His grace, His love, His peace.
Yes.
Christ is truly Emmanuel, that is God with us, day and night. He is in our midst. He dwells with us, full of grace and truth. He restores morality, nourishes virtues, consoles the afflicted, strengthens the weak.
Please.
Just as is in our day-to-day life, when we are sad, when you are afflicted, when you are overjoyed, in every moment we seek the company of
Jesus,
the beloved friend, the
non-natural
beloved friend. So we go and talk to the person. If the boy and
who is the closest,
if the boy and girl, they even, you know, fall down on the lap of the other person, just being there, and that itself consoles and, you know, restores your
entire
fiber of your life.
Yes.
In the same way, in all life, spiritual life, it is only Jesus to whom you can go. As I shared before, that man whose wife died previous night, the one who composed "What a Friend We Have in Jesus."
You see,
the going in the presence of Jesus restored him strength, brought him, you know, the spiritual fiber of his life, and to say that, whom can we go other than Jesus? Only in Jesus we find true peace, true happiness. The worldly things, they come and go, they pass.
Amen.
And therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, make effort. At least once a day if possible, or at least once a week, come before Jesus and spend as much time as possible. Once you begin, once you get the taste of it, it is like addiction.
Yeah.
Instead of getting addicted to all these dirty things, get addicted to the right person, get addicted to Christ, so that our life is blessed and that will bring us eternal life.
Amen. Amen. What Father said is so very true. All great people in the Catholic Church spend time at the Blessed Sacrament. That holy hour is like a routine. They will be there and they will sit with the Lord. And that has turned out to be their strength. And it is seen all over the world. And people know that there is a power behind them. There is a force behind them. We too can be one of those people. Father, let us pray.
God Almighty Father, thank you for your Son Jesus Christ, Emmanuel.
Yes, Lord.
God with us. You became
human
to be with us.
Jesus.
And when Jesus left this world, gave us the greatest sacrament, His memorial, the Eucharist. Give us the grace to nourish His presence and come to Him every moment of our life and be refreshed spiritually and materially also, but more spiritually, to seek strength, confidence, power, energy to do our life, to do our day-to-day's work, and to continue our life and to walk the path of faith. We ask it in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you. The Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus
Amen.
Loves you. Have a beautiful day.
Thank you. Thank you for being with us. Be good people. Take Father's advice. Spend time with the Blessed Sacrament. Amen.